Welcome to the Fashion Evolution exhibition here at the MetroDolls exhibit in Woodbridge Hilton, Iceland, New Jersey. We're starting in the 20s. This is a Fortuny Peplos gown, silk pleated gown from the 1920s, and it has a jacket by Babani, which is a skull stencil velvet. It's a silk, very sheer silk, and it's stenciled. But this is a peplos, you can see with the peplum effect there, and it's all, you know, it's like a puddling effect on the floor. We're moving to the 1930s. We have a Lucien Lelong ivory silk evening gown from about 1937. We have a photo here of it by Horst back in the year of 1937. And it does have a little train in the back, a little tail, and it's a beautiful bias cut gown, a good example of that period. And then next we have a Jean Paquin gown from around 1934. This is a dress, a dinner dress, of purple velvet and gold lame collar and cuffs. And a good example of a 30s dress that was below the knee. Then we have some accessories from the 30s. We have a pair of Jean Harlow's shoes. They're gold and they have a pattern here on the side and the heel. Typical little strapped shoe. And then we have a Bakelite and beaded evening bag from the 20s, late 20s, early 30s. Beautiful example of those Bakelite bags. Then we have a beautiful hat from Lily Dache that she used in her exhibitions in America and abroad. And it's all beaded and it has a little point. It's almost kind of like something Greta Garbo would wear, but it is from her personal collection. From the 40s, we have this beautiful Edward Molyneux black and brown silk crepe evening gown. It was a London gown when he fled from the from Paris to go to London to start his shop there while, you know, France was being taken over. So this is like a rare example of this gown. It is also in a book called The Fashion of the 40s that is in publication now. It's the exact one used in the book. Also from the 40s, we have this 1946-1947 Gilbert Adrian silk print day dress. Very common after Adrian left MGM. He started his own line in department stores and had his own little boutiques in those stores where he sold these dresses, and this is an original from the 40s. We move on to the 50s now. This is a 1955 Jean Dessay draped Grecian gown from around 1955 in blue and lavender, so it kind of has a purple effect. He was known for his draping and his pleating, as well as Fortuny and Madame Gray. This is a typical example of Jean Dessay. Around the corner here we have a Pierre Balmain ball gown. This is called Mademoiselle Jolie. Was made for that collection of for his perfume in 1954, and this was a signature gown for that perfume where he started that collection of perfume. And it's all beaded, lissage beading, and you can see it's a ice blue satin gown, and this is the Madame Jolie gown for that opening of that perfume. Next we have an haute couture Christian Dior evening ensemble. This is from autumn winter 1954 haute couture collection. It has a dress, a black brocade dress with a long peplum jacket over it. The undergarment is also made by Dior, but this is a very rare garment. You can see the photo at the bottom of the official L'Officiel picture of the ensemble from that period. Here we have a Chanel suit, a Lifetime Chanel from about 1963. And the Dior was Lifetime too. This is a Lifetime Chanel when she was still alive, and she made this suit. Very common. It has the chain at the bottom. It's blue with exposed stitching and her typical Chanel buttons. Very early 60s example of the boxy suits. Next we have a Jeffrey Bean evening gown from around 1965 with brown velvet and marabou evening gown. It's moving into the little flashier period when they would use more fun fabrics and that kind of thing. It has a satin belt as well. He was a great American designer. Then on the accessory table here, we have a William J. hat, who is Bill Cunningham, who is a famous fashion photographer now. He had a millinery shop in the early 50s for about 2 years. And this is a rare example of his work. It's circa 1950, and he's about 80, 82, 83 now. He still is a major fashion photographer. We have Christian Dior black kid gloves from the 50s that have never been used. We have some Jacquem evening shoes that are beaded and with sequins and beads. And then we have this little evening bag, which is from the estate of Lana Turner. It was a French bag, as most people bought these hand-beaded French bags. So it's very common of that era, but they're beautifully done. As we move into the 60s, we have a Jean Varon lime green and silver striped mini dress, circa 1966. He was known as John Bates. And he was located in London, and he was the inventor of the mini dress, or he was so attributed. And I have a photo of Twiggy wearing the same dress in a different colorway of red and silver, where this one is lime green and silver. And then we have the Rudy Gernreich dress from 1967. It's lime green knit and plastic. He was known for his knits. He was also known for the monokini and was a famous mod designer, American designer. So that's kind of where he made his mark. And you see a Time magazine cover with him and his model, Peggy Moffat, wearing the dress in white. Then we move over to Pierre Cardin from 1968. This is a black car wash dress because it's like a car wash when you take your car through the machine and it has the dancing ladies that go across your windshield. It's very heavy and is a really fine knit. And he was a big mod designer and space age designer. Now, in the 70s, we have Halston, who used a lot of chiffon and simple draping. And it's chiffon gown with attached drape. It's from 1973. There was also a similar one worn by Elizabeth Taylor in this color. He was known for the simple draping and custom work that he did. And now we'll move over to far more of the 80s. We're going to move into the 80s. This is a Gianni Versace 1982 lime green and metal Oriton dress. It's all metal. He did a collection of in 1982 of just this kind of metal. And this is a beautiful example of that with a little swing skirt. It's very heavy as well. Then we have an Issey Miyake origami coat dress. This is a very rare dress. It came from a Japanese woman who bought it in Japan in 1982. And it's all done by hand. It's circa 1983. And it's just a beautiful example of Issey Miyake in a more modern movement, avant-garde movement. In 1987, we have this Christian Lacroix poof dress, which is made of silk and a synthetic. There's a similar one in the Metropolitan Museum archive. And this one is a typical example of a poof dress that's sort of in between a tutu and a crinoline 50s dress. And this became a signature for him in that year. Then we have more accessories. These are from the 60s. We have some Courage go-go boots. Courage studied with Balenciaga and went out on his own. We do have a Balenciaga hat next to that. It looks kind of like pipe cleaners, but it is a felt, fabric, and it's early 60s. And then we have the little Poochie bag. Poochie was well known for his multicolored design, and this is a little box purse from 1968, somewhere in there. As we move into the 90s, we have Vivienne Westwood. This is from 1992, her portrait collection. This is a purple stencil velvet gown made after the marquetry in English furniture from the 1700s, and she copied that marquetry and put it on the dress. Then we have a Terry Mugler black linen dinner suit, circa 1994. He was known for his suits and still is, and he still designs. And this is a stunning example of an evening suit with a skirt and the top that has that sort of handkerchief effect to it. And lastly, we have an Alexander McQueen dress. It's a black bandage dress, similar to Hervé Léger and Alaya, circa 2004. It's a little unfinished sort of look to the bandage style. with a little bit of a extension to the arms where it makes it a little more gothic. And then it has two zippered sides. But it's a very form-fitting and beautiful piece. And that concludes our small exhibition on the evolution of fashion.